Hey, and welcome back to Channel Ship It Hala. Today I'm playing a standard daily events, as is the format of the current PTQ season. And I'm playing with the deck that just won the online PTQ, which is Nia Humans. Pretty straightforward deck. I mean, I'm sure you've seen it before. We've got a lot of creatures, a lot of synergistic interactions going on, a few burn spells, and a few lands. And this is exactly the deck list that won the PTQ. I don't actually have a lot of experience with the deck. For the most part, it's pretty streamlined. The sideboard is a little wonky, in my opinion. I mean, we've got a few different cards that I'm not really sure what they're for, like Gruul Charm. Pacifism, I could probably assume is for Thragtusk, but it's not good against Thragtusk if they have Restoration Angel. One of my biggest concerns with playing this deck is the mana. It really requires you to have perfect mana to be able to function. Which is why I'm a little curious why there's not at least one more land. Like, at the very least, that helps you cast your spells, even if it's one land too many. And also, I'm a little worried about the Reanimator matchup. There's not really any cards specifically for that matchup, from what I can tell. I guess Fiend Hunter is a good choice, but not perfect. I mean, we could have some form of Graveyard Hate, maybe. Although, to be fair, any Graveyard Hate would kind of dilute the deck. Although at the same time, most of the sideboard cards already do dilute the deck, which is why I probably won't be boarding in very many in any matchup. All right, here's a hand. No one drop. The only green source for our board is Cavern, so we're not gonna be able to cast other green cards like Experiment One and Mayor of Avabrook. And we're on the draw. This is actually, I mean, it looks like a fine hand. It's kind of borderline in my opinion. I think I'll keep this though. Okay. One drops might be too important with this deck. Important enough that I could have mulliganed and been okay with it. Though I'm still learning about this deck myself. Maybe this would have been better on the play, where I don't need a one drop as often. Okay, Mare. So I could. I could, like, just forget about the boar for a while and just play Mare with Cavern on human. That way I can cast my other human. My other green humans. And then. I could add. Well, let's see. What. We could add Frontline Medic to the board, and then on turn four, potentially two Maulers. That's not very aggressive. The bonus to playing Mayor first is that he may end up not having a spell, in which case we could pump out some wolves, or at least one wolf. Probably two. There's also the possibility of Searing Spearing his Arbor Elf, which is like pretty bad actually for this deck. I think the best thing I can do is get Mayor into play. If I got Mauler down and then Medic'd, I could attack for five. But the fact that he has Arbor Elf means that he's probably just gonna block the Mauler. That's not really ideal. And I guess I wouldn't have to attack with Mauler. I just attack for three, and then next turn I could bore haste eight with indestructible. Tragic slip. Yeah, I think we're just dead now. If, like, this is the board state, we just can't win. Olivia is not sticking around. And this matchup's probably a nightmare to begin with. They have efficient removal and they have insane creatures for this matchup. Well, I'm sure he has something here. A removal spell of some kind. Actually, so he's in an attack. I guess he's could just be playing around Lightning Mauler, but if he's missing his land drop, he probably wouldn't block anyway. So what could he? What four mana card could he have? I'm not really sure. Yeah, we'll just drop Mayor Mauler. Let's see if we. Actually, it's kind of tricky. So we can pair attack for three. But the next turn we'd have to draw a land to be able to make our best possible play. Think we just don't pair. I don't know. It could get greedy. If I draw a land, then I can go Mauler Medic attack for 11. I can still attack for 11 if I draw a land. Just miss out on 3 points. Oh man, this is really sad. Still can't cast his boar. I don't know. Playing around bonfire, playing around cards is probably relevant in this matchup, but it's like there's so many different cards to play around. It's Seems very difficult. Like if I anticipated Bonfire, I obviously would make a different play. But then yeah, then I just get Liliana'd. It's like impossible to do it. Yeah, it's actually impossible. I think everything I've done has been fine. Just ignore what he's doing because there's too many variables. Hey, I can cast Boar now. So I guess I do. Let's see. Yeah, I'd rather cast this than give it haste. And then we can pair with Burning. Or we can pair with Boar. Right, well, now we have a board presence. Burning Tree Emissary is a card. Probably Thragtusk. Yeah. Right, here we are. Actually, pretty stable now. I mean, he still has at least two spells in hand. Actually, he's just gonna try to kill us. Awkward. Think we definitely have to trade the boar here. If we let him pump for four. Yeah, we would be dead next turn, so. Great. Yeah, I think we're dead now. It's only a little late for experiment one. Yeah, he blocks two power creatures. We just can't win at this point. Let's see, if we let him attack, we pretty much have to block. And then we have no chance of killing him. that I can see, so we'll just concede. Let's see. So there's so many things they have that are good against us. I really don't know what our best options are here. Mark of Mutiny on Thragtusk is fine, but that requires us to be in a game state where we actually still have board presence. Pacifism's probably better against Thragtusk, because then we don't have to be really far ahead on board. But then there's also Olivia. So we probably have to have Fiend Hunter for Olivia. Thalia, I do want, of course. And then Pacifism. Let's see, so I think I have to cut Searing Spear. Well, if I cut Searing Spear, I'm cutting an answer to Olivia. So it kind of defeats the purpose of Fiend Hunter. Actually, Fiend Hunter could just be killed anyways. So I'm just not going to do that. I'm just going to leave in the Searing Spears. See, this could kill Olivia. This could kill Olivia, and it can, like, bypass Thragtusk if we're really far ahead on board. Still really pretty narrow. Don't really want that. And pacifism might just be too narrow to bring in. So then we'd end up just bringing in one Thalia. And I still don't even know what to cut for that. I would cut a spear, but we need those for Olivia. As far as I can tell, all these cards are still pretty good. Boros Elite might be actually the worst card. Requires three creatures, and I mean, otherwise it's very bad. So it requires three creatures. I guess we'll just cut one. Though, still, one drops might be pretty key here, so I maybe shouldn't cut that. I mean, the next thing is probably Lightning Mauler, which is also just fine. It's just impossible to make. Look at the crap.